When we're working to find the y-intercept, also known as the initial value, and the rate of change, also known as slope, in our context, the y-intercept, our initial value, shows up right here. Nora has two stuffed unicorns. So our beginning, the initial value we're starting with is 2. This is our y-intercept. In our table, looking when x is 0 at the very beginning, this gives us our y-intercept. We have 2 when x is 0, so this is the y-intercept. On our graph, when x is 0, we go up and find that the points cross or intersect the y-axis at 0, 2. So this point is our y-intercept. In our equation, the y-intercept is the number. We don't have our x with it, so we're not looking at our variable term. We are looking at just the number. So our 2 here, or here, is the y-intercept. When we're looking for rate of change or slope, that is what are we changing by as we keep going. In this case, we're talking in terms of weeks, what's happening every week. Nora is buying 3 more unicorns. So for every passage of another week, Nora's increasing her amount of unicorns by 3. So this 3 tells us what our rate of change or slope is. Increasing by 1 week, we're increasing by 3 more unicorns. In our table, we see that as we increase by 1, increasing by 1s, on the x, we're increasing by 3s on the y's. So we're increasing by this 3 on the y for every 1 on the x. This is our rate of change, or our slope. In the graph, when we are looking for our rate of change or our slope, we can think rise over run. That is, how much up are we going? In this case, we're going from 2 to 3, 4, up to 5, to then run or move left-right one place. So we went up 3 to go 1 to the right. Then we got to our next point. Once again, we're going up 1, 2, 3, up 3 to go over 1. So we're rising or going up 3 to move 1 to the right. And this 3 over 1 is our rate of change or our slope. In the equation, with the x in our variable term, the coefficient, the number in front of the x, gives us our rate of change or our slope. We have 3, or 3 over 1. That is our rate of change, or our slope. And so in our equation, we just look and can pull these numbers out, given that the rate of change, or our slope, is the number with the x, and the y-intercept is the number by itself.